The pub is arguably one of Britain's cultural icons. However, that could be set to change. Whether it's in the middle of a rural village or on the corner of a bustling high street, a closed pub is an increasingly common sight. Research published in the journal BMC Public Health found that nearly 30% of young people class themselves as non-drinkers. It's perhaps because of this that there are now 13% fewer pubs in the UK than in 2002. According to the non-profit organisation The Campaign for Real Ale, also known as CAMRA, pubs contribute £23.1 billion to the British economy each year. So, is there any way to stop them from closing? Or will the decline inevitably continue? Dave Jones, owner of the White Horse Pub and Inn in Leighton Buzzard, certainly seems to think it will.
Well, thank God I've got a B&B, really. Otherwise, I think I'd be shut by now, to be honest. Basically, if you don't have... if it's not a foodie pub or you've got, say, a B&B, you can't really rely on wet sales these days.
But a decline in alcohol consumption doesn't have to spell disaster for Britain's many taverns. Children are now an accepted presence in several pubs, and many, having seen the sale of alcoholic beverages slump in recent years, have taken the opportunity to remodel themselves as more family-friendly and food-focused, offering up lattes, cappuccinos, and mocktails, as well as the usual beer and wine. More non-alcoholic options are good news for our health too. A Lancet paper published in April reported that every drink over the daily recommended limit will cut half an hour from the expected lifespan of a 40-year-old, and that regularly exceeding 12 and a half units, about 5 pints, in a week greatly increases the risk of stroke, heart failure, and several forms of cancer. Adrian Sandy, from South London, who suffers from epileptic simple partial seizures, has felt the benefit from cutting alcohol out of his life.
I suffer from seizures, so I know that if I give up the alcohol, I definitely don't have as many seizures because I think that they probably triggered them. I felt a lot better. I don't obviously have the hangovers that people have. Definitely felt a lot fresher when I don't drink. I'm feeling a lot fresher, so it's easier to drink water or any other non-alcoholic drinks when I'm out. I can have a much better night out and be out a lot later as well.
But not everyone is cutting down. Even with the growing awareness of alcohol's negative impact, drinking among the middle-aged population has not declined. We all know plenty of people who hold out for those articles proposing that red wine is good for blood pressure and that whiskey helps prevent heart disease, for example. While some of the middle-aged might feel pleased with themselves for leaving their binge drinking past behind, the regular daily consumption might actually be doing more damage to their bodies, as NHS health experts warn that the organs which metabolise alcohol, the liver and stomach, shrink with age so it stays in the system for longer. Dee Stevenson from Bedfordshire describes her daily drinking habits as those of a functioning alcoholic. The classic description of an alcoholic is someone whose life is falling apart because of how much they drink. But that's not always the reality. Some people seem to be doing fine, even though they drink above the recommended limit daily. Experts call these people functional or high-functioning alcoholics.
I go to the pub every weekend with my partner. I enjoy going to the pub because I like to socialise with people. And I drink because I'm a functioning alcoholic. Years ago, I used to enjoy the thrill of drinking, but now it's just a habit. I drink every day. That's what most functioning alcoholics do. It just gets me out the house and I meet new people. Well, not new people because they're all coming at the same time and what have you, but yeah, it's just nice to get out and socialise.
Surprisingly, the fact is that the middle-aged population may prove to be the last generation who drink in this way. Just as young people are changing the worlds of environmentalism and social politics, it's possible that this shift in the British attitude to alcohol will stand to last. We can't know for sure, of course, but it's never looked more likely than it does currently that the boozy Briton stereotype could, in time, be put to bed.